Ja, good morning. Thank you so much, dear Dr. Dhanpat Agarwal, dear colleagues, dear friends. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for the opportunity given to me to speak here and to participate. I have enjoyed these conferences since 9 years, I think now, a lot, because right from the beginning I felt that the spirit which was represented here by the speakers and the items discussed had a lot to do with the real reason we in the industrialized, more industrialized world in the OECD countries had given to the emerging economies, namely by saying in Article 7 TRIPS, everybody agreed to that, that intellectual property rights, strong ones I may add, are there in order to promote transfer of technology, to make it easier. That means, for example, patents. I'm a patent man. I know about trademarks, but I'm a physicist and a technical person, so to say, so I would like to concentrate on patents. That they are essentially not there to monopolize technologies, innovations developed, but to give the possibility to share their result at a fair price with others, to make out of an, as Dr. Agarwal said, out of an invention, a innovation packaged in a little parcel which is built and held together by a patent or a portfolio of patents which you can send away to give to others at a fair price. This is something which was always here in the discussion, not so much to prohibit others to do what is patented, but to give others the possibility to share, to participate in the so patented result of inventions and innovations. Over the years, I have observed here in India as an outsider, I am a German, but I have had the chance and still have the chance to come here for many opportunities and to share my views and to work also with companies and clients who are more and more participating in the intellectual property world and in the way that patents can be used reasonably in the sense maybe of Article 7 TRIPS. I have seen that the understanding of the authorities and economy and lawyers and patent expert colleagues here in India has shifted more and more from this original pure idea of if you have an invention, you wish to patent it in order to monopolize it, to a viewpoint where people have understood, particularly in high-tech industry, that you need patents and you should use them in order to create freedom to operate, in order to have something to offer to others which may have patents you need or would like at least to use in order to enter certain fields of technology. So this aspect of packaging patent portfolios together, which can be used then as a currency to get cross licenses, gives an insight into a very specific aspect of this Article 7 meaning of TRIPS, namely that patents, other intellectual property rights also, of course, are there to transfer technology. Cross-licensing is a specific kind of licensing which gives the chance to freely do what you have developed, respecting patents of others, but at the same time having a currency available instead of cash money to buy the permittance to use certain technologies. That leads me to some suggestion, and I would like to use this as a little bit extensive conclusion maybe of what I want to say here, is that countries like India, in the present state of industry and industrial development, should make it a little bit easier, I think, to patent improvements of already patented substances, technologies, and you name it. Why? The easiest way, particularly for a small and medium-sized enterprise with limited R&D budgets, to create opportunities for getting licenses from patents of originators, whether this is a patent on a pharmaceutical substance, on a special software-related invention or whatsoever, a telecommunication system, is that they concentrate their R&D budget onto improvements of already existing patented subjects or objects, and if it is too difficult to get patents on that, you cannot create a currency which would otherwise enable you to go to the owner of an original patent, of a priorly obtained patent already, and ask, would you allow me to make this, I don't know what, aspirin, which you have patented in India, and to make it, and I give you a license under my improved patent, aspirin, and then we can exchange this. I think India is a typical example. In India, we have two typical examples where it is too difficult, I think, to patent improvements. Both examples are here, I think, I would use them from pharma industry. You have the one example that we have this, it was already cited, 3D, that we have this enhanced efficacy, which I fully understand requirement, in order not to make it, and I think this is the viewpoint of the legislator, very understandable and legitimate, not to make it too easy for owners of, for example, pharmaceutical basic patents to what sometimes is called a little bit misleadingly evergreening the protection on that subject. But what is misunderstood is that not all, and I think by far not all, patents or patent applications on improvements, whether it is on a molecular scale, whether it is on compositions of pharmaceuticals, whether it is even in second medical use instances, that it is not always the originators. I think only in a minority, the originators and owners of the original patents who make these inventions and try to patent them, but it is the newcomers. And if you make it possible for newcomers to get patents, dependent patents, of course, in patent terminology, on these further developments, you guarantee to